Mine is to say that they came on Friday, and we were surprised to learn that they had retained some of the keys which they had not handed over and accessed their offices. But that has now been rectified, and today they came back to see me, but we had prearranged meetings which are for activities of the commission, and those meetings are ongoing up to now. So I didn't manage to see them, but I asked them to go and put in writing what they want to see me about, and if and when they do so, then we shall address the issues which they may want to deal with. Today actually happens to be the day when we promulgated the constitution, the 2010 constitution. And in that constitution, we have chapter 6, which deals with the integrity of public servants. And so if you are a former commissioner, you have cleared with the commission, and you walk back saying, I want to sit here and work, there's everything wrong. I mean, it's absolutely wrong for you to go back to where you used to work and say, I want to work, without maybe being reappointed to the position, which again is not possible with the IEBC, because you serve once and go. So the issue of whether there's mischief or not, I think all of us can see. No. What the judge said is that the procedure of the commissioner's resigning was not clear, and I don't know whether the judge had all the information before her, because as far as the commissioners are concerned, in another case filed by activist Tom Tata, they saw affidavit saying they wrote to the president. That's all they are required to do. The only shortcoming of that is that they did not copy that letter to the commission. Now, come to that judgment you are talking about. The judge said the resignation was unprocedural, but the judge went ahead and said it's in public domain that these commissioners resigned. And the judge went ahead to say that the replacement of the vacancies must be done by way of appointing new commissioners. That's in the judgment. The salaries of the commissioners of IEBC is paid by a consolidated fund. That's through Treasury. It's not the commission that pays. And as we speak, immediately they resigned, I wrote to the Treasury, the PS, to stop their salaries. Now, I'm not certain whether that was done. Up to now, I've not got a feedback on my letter, but I believe that Treasury acted on the recommendations from the commission that they are no longer in office, and I hope they are not being paid.